Hello, hello, hello everyone, and welcome to our channel. Today I am here to share with you a quick altered journal cover with a denim. And this is a journal which I had handmade long time back. So to begin, I have applied some clear gesso on top of it. And now I am using some light paste and applying it randomly over my cover. We'll be catching up for the final pictures at the end of the tutorial. Here is this purple stencil which I took long time back from Ipsy Bipsy, and I'm using to create some background in circles. So I'm just quickly applying some quick texture here and there to make the base of my layout. I recently started doing this journaling. This was my very first journal in this notebook, and I just thought to do a quick cover here. Now I'm going to use this script new stencil from Finnabear, and I'm adding some script here, and I'm just adding a little bit to around it so that it's visible when I complete my layout. Just quickly using my light paste to add some scripting here and there. So I'm really loving this new stencil from Finnabear, and it gives a lot of detailing to your projects. I'm very new to mixed media, but yet I love I love to do mixed media just to have some break from everyday scrapbooking and paper crafting, and this is just for fun. And so I decided to do this journal and alter this cover, and I had something, I had this old denim with me, and I just wanted to do something with it, and it just came to a random idea to my mind to why not do a quick tutorial about how I did this, and it may help you also to try something out with your old denim which has been just kept lying around here in your house. I am also using this green color chalk paint, and I am using these two spray paints from Lindy's. One is in shades of pink and another one is in blue. You can check out the names of these sprays in my description box. And I'm just quickly randomly applied here and there, and then I'm drying it up with my heat tool. So I haven't had any idea what I'll be ending up doing this. I was just enjoying the process, and it doesn't matter to me how it looks. It was more of enjoying the process. Here I have taken some molds from Prima, and I'm just quickly adding it to create some layers before I go ahead and add my florals and everything. And this is a die cut from Fantasy Dyes, and I'm also going to add it to add some more details and layer. I'll be placing it with the help of this chipboard. And I'm just going to stick it here. I am just loving the new new upcoming range from Fantasy Dyes in India, and trying to make use of them. And I'm very new to journaling. I don't know how to do it. One of my friends told me that you have to just enjoy the process of doing this. So here I am trying something new. Now I'm picking up few elements and some lace pieces to add to my layout. And I'm just randomly adding it here and there. Taking out some fuzzy cut elements from different packs that I have used before, and finally taking flowers from Prima. Before adding the flower, I am adding some this, I don't know what we say, call it. I just found it in some gift wrapping, something to that is stuffed in the base. So I just kept it for making use in my craft projects. So we crafters always keep on collecting things from our households to make use of it someday So this is how I have placed my flowers in. So I have kept it very simple, very minimalistic, and not doing too much, because it was my general cover and it will be opened so many times. I didn't want it to add any such element which might disturb and later on, you know, not stay there. So I'm just using very lesser things. I'm just making more use of more of flowers. Now I have taken this small pebbles from Finnabear and soft matte gel, I guess, yeah, to add some stones. These are the, I think these are the medium sized stones from Finnabear, and I'm just randomly adding it around my whole layout that I have created. And I just love these, and I just love adding these. I just love the whole idea of how mixed media is done, because you know, you have to more of enjoy the process of how you create your layout and add so many things to it, and I just enjoy doing it. So I hope this video you're liking the process, and do subscribe to my channel if you're liking it, and stay tuned with for more upcoming projects and inspirations and my trials and experiments with mixed media, paper crafting, scrapbooking and whatnot, and so many inspirations from my influencers. So I try to get as many as inspirations for you all. So please stay with us, do subscribe. I'm adding some more finish by adding this bubbles, I think, yeah, honeycomb stenciling here using my archival ink in black. I'm just randomly doing it here and there. You know, while you're doing a mixed media layout, it's just something goes in your mind and you just decide about, you know, where it's looking nice, and if the layering is coming out good, if there is a good composition coming out. It just goes in your mind and you keep on doing it that the way your mind says. And now I'm finally adding some this blue Lindy shakers from Lindy's. This is these sparkles I'm using to add some more depth and detailing to my whole composition that I have created. And I'm just randomly adding it around my flower and my mold and my all the elements, just to give it a little depth. And I'm just misting it with some water to, you know, blend in and not look like I have created a background kind of thing around my whole composition. So I'm just letting it, you know, spread on its own, flow, just go like that. And I'm just quickly heat drying everything. And I hope you guys are liking my altered cover. I am liking it very much. And I hope you will try something doing with your old denim, maybe do something in mixed media or scrapbooking. I will surely try this method to do some scrapbooking also in coming future. Let's see. Now I'm just doing the final step of splattering some black gesso onto my project. And I'll be also doing the same using some white gesso. I really love splattering this. This is the best ending that I could do to my projects, and I just love doing this, and the way it splatters all over my clothes also sometimes. So this is how my project looks. Finally adding a sentiment. This is from Prima's Apricot Honey collection, and I'll be adding it using some chipboard. So I'll be adding two layers of chipboard below it to, you know, give it a little height, also create a little dimension. So this is how I'm going to place my sentiment here, and this this is what is the final look. I hope you enjoyed watching my tutorial. I'll be coming up with some more and more inspirations for you all. Here are some quick final pictures. I thank you so much to you all for watching. Have a good day. Bye-bye.